Don't make too much noise. Be cool.
Stop.
Can I tell y'all something?
Yes.
All right, listen, especially you. I want to tell you something. A lot of people will watch you, like, listen, watch y'all on the knowledge, and they watched y'all, you feel me? And you ain't know the answers to the knowledge, man. You know? And you like, well, Chief, why are they here? I want to tell you something about intelligence. The word intelligence means, can you tell her? Hold on, what's wrong with him? Hold on. I'm going to go check up on him. What's wrong with him? Hold on. I'm gonna be right back. Why is he screaming like this? What's wrong with him? She in there? What's wrong with him?
I don't know. He's just screaming.
Can you give him the brush?
Yeah, I am now.
Okay, thanks. I don't know, he just screaming. And then she pops the breast in his mouth. Okay, he cool. He just wanna eat. When they growing like that, sometimes you gotta start giving them more and more. I wanna talk to y'all about intelligence and information.
Yeah.
And I wanna talk to you especially, because why is she doing this, man? You know what he wants? He wants to take, just talk. No, she can hear me. Do the thing. Just give him the breast. Give him some bananas. You know what he's screaming about? He just want to eat more and more and more. He is growing like a chia pet. Right?
Okay.
Okay. So, now, I wanted to talk to you because recently, Malia, don't do that one.
I'm about to record it. I like to record your voice.
Oh, God. Of course, you record everything. All right, so listen, I want to say this. If you made it to me, you are fucked. You're a genius.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying to you? Everybody's intelligence is different. Okay. Intel is information formulating from your genes. Malia, you have what is called intuition. Okay. Some people are innately smart. You know what I mean? They know things without knowing them. You understand what I'm saying? Now, you were drawn to me for a reason, right? But you didn't particularly know. Is like, but you knew the knowledge a little bit, but you might not know all the intricate details of the knowledge, but you had intuition. You innately knew what to do. You understand what I'm saying? That's why you have to always look at yourself as intelligent, because intuition is another intelligent that's gifted to females and women. Now, every woman that watched me might not know why she watched me. She might not know all the damn knowledge. But she barking up the right tree. I mean, eventually you're going to get the knowledge. But I feel like you are super intelligent because you were able to follow. You were able to find me. Oh, my God. What is going on? Come on. Let's go see what's going on. Let's go see. Yeah, let's see what's going on. You got him some more? What's wrong?
I think he's teething or something. I'm not sure. Like, I even put the breath in his mouth and he just...
God, that boy big. What? What's wrong?
I think his gums are hurting.
You teething?
Because when I feed him for a little bit, but then, because he already, I know he's full because he spit up, like he couldn't handle them.
Yeah, he's big, big chunky man.
Usually he puts his own hands in his mouth, but I think he was just irritated.
He wanted to move around.
Yeah.
Okay, he wanted to go outside. Mm-hmm. All right, man. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
You ever notice I don't pick up other people's children? You ain't never noticed me. I don't never pick up no another man. I'll never pick up another man baby, dog. I never do it. I don't even touch other people's children. I'm not in. I don't do that. You know what I'm saying? You never see me picking up Jaomi. You never see me picking up other people's kids. I don't do that shit. And so for my universe to show me Omac picking up my baby, that shit was weird to me, because I never, even here, I never pick I don't pick up another man's child, bro. I mean, I'm cool with them, and you know what I'm saying? I just feel like that's the ultimate disrespect, to touch another man's child. Like, and even when I'm with another shorty, when I was with Maisha, she had other children, I had a relationship with them, but I always leave room for their daddy, because you know what I'm saying? Like, you always, that's just out of respect, out of a man. A man will feel that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Men, we feel that. So, like, nah, I'm not playing that.
You know what's kind of pausing? Is it pausing?
No. It's just weird as fuck. You know, it is. It is a weird thing. And so, because that's how I am, I'm always the type. You know what I'm saying? Like, how often do you see me pick these kids up?
Nah, I seen you hold John one time.
One time? Yeah. And I picked him up on some shit. It's something innately in me. It's a principle and a moral inside of you that just won't let you do it like that, because that's that man child. You feel what I'm saying? And it's something that's just reflective in yourself. So when I seen that shit, I was like, wow. I think that was the ultimate disrespect. Like, I was like, whoa. That was the ultimate disrespect. That was like some crazy shit. Like, wow. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you want to fight me? You want to fight? Like, do you want those problems? Like, you know what I mean? Like, that was like fighting shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, wow. Like, you know? Yeah. Even though that never crossed my mind to fuck him up, but in my mind, in my lower shit, you know what I mean? If I was in the States, he would never do that.
Right.
Like, if I was in the United States, he would never do that.
Right.
Ever. Never. Like, you know I was there. You know I'm in the tropics. Well, I ain't gonna do nothing. But if I was in the States and you guys seen that.
Because even in the animal kingdom,
that doesn't fly. Nah. Even in the animal kingdom, it don't fly.
Right.
Yeah, in the animal kingdom, that don't even go.
Okay.
It don't even go like that in the animal kingdom. That's just crazy. But anyway, moving back to what I was saying to y'all. You know, intelligence, man. You have an intuition, okay? Intuition is something that doesn't have maybe the facts behind it, but it innately knows what to do. Look at where you're at and look at where they're at. So how can anyone say you're dumb as rocks or you're dumb as anything? You right with Chief. I'm here. I knew where to go.
Mm-hmm.
Nigga, I might not know all the details, but I know this is right. My heart is telling me, and my everything in me is telling me this is right. You know what I'm saying? And that thing that led you to me is called intuition, and your intuition is on point. And so now is to learn why. You know, your intuition is like, now is to understand. Why now you here to understand why you did it, so that you can validate your intuition to yourself, and then always know that your truest power in this life might not be to be the most knowledgeable, but your intuition is your gift. That's your gift. And so what you're gonna find out is like, damn, I was right. Without none of all of this knowledge, I innately knew what to do. And that's where the feminine power is the innate ability to know when something is right. The intuition that says, you know what, this is it right here. You understand what I'm saying? This is what I need. This is what I need. I don't know why, but I'm here. And motherfucker be looking confused. They be like, she don't know the knowledge. And no one looking like, but the motherfucker here. Mm-hmm. The motherfucker packed up and left and is here.
Right. It's a lot of
people. Where the fuck you at?
Right.
Half y'all got most of the knowledge and still won't follow your intuition. Yeah. You innately knew what to do. It's a lot of people that follow me that's supposed to have been here with me, walking with me. But guess what? They second guess their intuition. And so they start watching hater videos. They start finding flaws. They start finding this wrong, that wrong. And they stop their own self from leveling up and getting what they needed. I commend Malia. I think Malia dope. That's why I ain't letting her go. Because you innately knew what to do. You understand what I'm saying? And that's powerful. And that's a woman's power. Intuition is knowing without knowing.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? It's just knowing without knowing. And so, you know what I'm saying? Like, you might not.
Told them.
Exactly.
This is what I want to do. They looked at me like, I'm
saying, you what?
I've been like months before I even came here, like a fucking year prior. I wanted to come here. They looked at me like I was crazy. So I was just like, nah.
Same thing with Bambi. Bambi had tried to do this in Costa Rica before she even knew about car. It's like she innately knew what to do but didn't have the knowledge. And that's what women are driven on. Women are driven on intuition. That's a feminine aspect. And even in males, we're supposed to have intuition as well. But your intuition is your gift. You might not have all the fucking knowledge. You might be walking around here with that and all the fuck. That ain't your gift. That ain't your gift. But what does it matter as long as you do the right thing? You did the right thing. You feel me? Now you're here to learn why you did it. Right? Now you're here to learn the mathematics, which isn't your strongest point. But wherever you're weak, you're strong somewhere else. So never, always know what your gift is, because you might not know the knowledge as far as the mathematics, but your heart is pure. And never forget that. And a lot of women out there are like that. They innately knew what to do, but they like, yo, why do I like this man so much? I can't stand him, but I like him. It's the intuition. It's why you love me. You love me because why you keep watching me? It's your intuition that you're ignoring. So a lot of women try to use their logic, which has been programmed wrong. They got the wrong knowledge in there that's going against the knowledge. And they're like, oh, no, that don't add up to my information. Well, that's why you got to empty your cup. Your heart ain't pure yet. You got to be baptized. You understand what I'm saying? So I just want all y'all to know, you are all wise in your own way. And each one of you have your own gifts. And the truth about the whole matter is, look, you have to hone in on your gift. Each one of you have some kind of intelligence that is fucking stupid sharp and genius sharp. Each one of you are geniuses because you're here. You understand? Anybody that's not here for the right reason is going to get kicked out eventually. You're going to get the fuck out. You understand what I'm saying? So, like, always understand to yourself, like, look, I'm here, you're there, you can't call me dumb at all. You're dumb. You're still living there. I might not know all the knowledge and not knew all the fucking information, but I had intuition. That is an intelligence of knowing something without knowing, an innate intelligence. And you moved on that intelligence, which is even more intelligent. You know what I'm saying? And you move toward what? Someone that could teach you why. And you're willing to learn. That's all that need. That's all that you need in life. And you're willing to learn. You're not resisting. You're not like, well, you're like, well, I don't know, but I'm willing to learn. And so if you're willing to learn, you're going to win. You're going to win. You're going to the top. I just had to let y'all know that today. I'll be busting y'all chops. But I want you to know that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Don't listen to what people saying. Oh, you don't know this. You don't know. Your intelligence is in a different compartment. Point blank, period. And the more we try to teach you the other way of learning, the more we're taking away from that intuition. Because your intuition is king. Because it got you here.
Yeah.
So I need to fuck with your intuition. Whatever you be feeling, I need to tap into that. I need to tap into her. We all need to tap into her intuition. We, before things happen, she innately knows, which that's her gift. So that lets us know she's prophetic. She's prophetic. She can actually tell us what she feels if she can have confidence in that. So once she gets the knowledge and know that, yo, I was right. Whoa, I was right. I was right on the money the first time. That's that Aries. That Aries is about precision without thinking. Aries ain't about thinking. It's about action. Yeah. It's about movement without thinking. It's about accuracy without thinking. To the point of, and Aries is about accuracy without thought. It's on the impulse, but it's accurate. So you got that Aries thing going. Now you're here to balance that energy, to take the intuition, which was already your intelligence. That's your real intelligence. It's to, you be having thoughts, premonitions, things that come to you that you be nervous about. And you here to learn that that's your true gift. Your true gift is your intuition. So let's give her a hand. Someone said he's a whole pep and they don't see it. Please, no. That's right. They're right. I'm pimping. What am I pimping her into?
Knowledge of yourself.
The divine knowledge of self.
Facts.
Yeah. You better get you a pep like me.
Right.
A player into making progress. Because we making progress over here. I'm pimping you into what? Into what? That's what I want to understand. I'm pimping you into your natural beauty, into veganism, into connecting to the earth, knowledge yourself, astrology, biology, quantum physics. You better go get a pimp like me. You better go get a pimp like me. What am I pimping them into? You could say, nigga, please. But look at them. They naturally beauty. They ain't got no makeup on. They don't have no weave in their hair. I have them facing their natural beauty so that they can be embrace their own real, true, organic selves. What am I pimping them to do, shorty? Look at these women. They play chess. I got them playing chess. Good chess players now. Decent play chess players. Go get y'all notebooks. Let's go into their notebooks. Go ahead, pull your notebooks. Let's see what I'm pimping them to do. Let's see your notes. Let's see what I'm teaching these women here. Let's see what the pimping ain't easy. Open them up. Okay, so this is your notebook. Let's see what I'm pimping my people around to do. Seem like knowledge itself. This is yours? Okay, show us what you got here. What you got?
Science behind
Papa's chicken mind. Science behind Papa's chicken mind control, genetics, holographic universe.
Saving Babylon's
a fuck no. Currently, what you got? Show me. Run us through it. What we got? We got books and books of knowledge here.
Astrology here.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what we pimping y'all to do. Since you've been with me, let's see what I'm pimping you to do. Players into making progress. Astrology.
We got poems here.
Poetry, making poetry. Sure that you keep writing all your thoughts out, making sure you have an outlet. You know. What are you eating today? What are you putting in your vessel?
This here is all from the earth. Almonds, nuts. This is beans, rice.
Oh, so I make you eat from the earth. I'm pimping you that for good health.
Yes.
Okay, so pimping ain't easy. Or pimping ain't easy. If you know what I'm saying? Am I telling you to go out here and sell your pussy?
No. Hell no.
Hell no. That pussy belongs to who?
You.
Who that pussy belongs to?
You.
Yeah.
And me only.
And me only. Yeah. So a pimp is, let's educate people what a pimp is. A pimp is someone that tells women, black women, to take their body and sell their body for money. Yep. And then give that money to him. Right. That's exactly what I'm not. I'm educating you about who you truly are and showing the world that and expressing that through you. Expressing my knowledge of self through you. And that is a form of what they call pimping, what pimping would be, or the infrastructure of pimping. And if that's the case, then you go on to fucking work every day as pimping.
Right.
You going to Babylon job every fucking day is pimping, and then your boss is pimping you to do his fucking work or for his agenda, which is teaching you what? The world is filled with pimps' nose. We'll just talk about those I know. You feel me? So it is what it is. It is what it is. You feel what I'm saying? If you call this pimping, you better find a pimp like me.
That's
right. You know? So it is what it is. Moving forward. I just want y'all to know that y'all intelligence, find your intelligence. Know that you innately knew what to do. You know what I'm saying? You made some mistakes. That's part of Aries. Aries is they be on point, but they've missed out on details. And that's okay, because you got a man to do what? At least you found a man that can help you stabilize your mind. That can help you better yourself. You feel what I'm saying? So shit, you're doing good. You're doing better than a lot of women. You feel what I'm saying? And I commend you. I, for one, think you a genius. I, for one, for you to even innately know to come to me. You know what I'm saying? A seventh dimensional being. I am a seventh dimensional being. I am the Christ consciousness. I am the Messiah. There's no greater consciousness than the one I give you. So you innately knew to do that at your young age. You could have been out here doing some dumb shit, busting your ass open, out here being a thot, but you wanted to get knowledge yourself. And you was able to sacrifice whatever to do that. And that shit is commendable. And that right there makes your heart pure. And all the other details and what people want to make you feel bad for and all that shit, listen, we can figure that out.
Yep, that's right.
Your heart is pure. And that's that. Let's give her a hand. So we need to come to you about what you feel about certain things that maybe we going through. What should we do? Because you probably in your head already know the answer. And I think we should use your gifts in that way. You know what I'm saying? Because it's real. That's real. You know? So, and you too. Well, you had the highest score. You had one of the highest scores. Yeah. Yeah. But I think that woman, your intuition has to be appreciated more as far as innately knowing what to do. Because I feel like y'all the most smartest woman on the planet. Not, when I say smart, I'm not talking about the knowledge as far as knowing the calculated knowledge. Shit, there's a story in the Bible where it says there were two sons. And there was a father, and the father told both the sons to go do some work in the yard. And the first son said, sure, I'll do it, and talk to his father and tell him, yeah. And the second son said, nah, I'm not doing it. But later on, the son that said that he would do it didn't do it, and the son that said that he wouldn't do it fucked around and did it. See, it's not what you know. It's what you can apply to what you do. It's your actions that matter. But you here, they there. You doing what it takes to do the work on yourself. They not. You studying. You in it. And you might not still have the confidence within yourself that gives you the ability to be like, oh yeah, all out. Oh, you not, you know, women should be seen, not heard. There's a mystery to you, and maybe you not all out in the open and all out loud like Umi, or all out, nah, maybe you more subtle with your femininity. Maybe you introverted. Maybe you are someone that, you know, internalizes a lot of your thoughts. You understand what I'm saying? That's why y'all books is so heavy and all the pages. You're like, oh, you want to look at my book for real? Because if I really want to get to know y'all, all I got to do is look at these books right here. Like, anybody don't want to get to know y'all, they just look at what you're writing on, baby. What you got? Because this is what's on your mind right here. It's in this book. You know what I'm saying? You got your little tabs up here. Like, little sections. And how many books do you have like these?
Two.
Two? Mm-hmm. You got two of them since you've been here? Mm-hmm. Since you've been here, you got two books full of knowledge. Have you ever, like, looked back into the knowledge and read it?
Oh, yeah. Every time I make something out of it, what I wrote down, I circle it and check it.
And people keep bringing up Google. Like, what's wrong with this stuff being on Google? Google is just an interface for knowledge. Right. There's nothing wrong with the knowledge on Google.
Right.
You should utilize Google. I'm sorry, before there was Google, there was just the library. I mean, why people make fun of people that be on Google? I'm sorry, like, you don't use Google? It's a digital library. So, that's like making fun of you because you at the library.
Access to everything literally in your hand, why not
utilize it? Right. It's knowledge. You know what I'm saying? What's wrong with you? Oh, that stuff's on Google. Then if it's on Google, then why aren't you studying?
Right.
If it's that easy, then why aren't you studying? Why aren't you teaching it? Why aren't you teaching it? Because we are in an information age, and each and every person is born with a message. Here's what we don't understand about life. And I'm gonna teach you this, watch. Each and every person, when you're born with an innate knowledge that is called information. You're born with a message. Each and every, no one can teach you how to be you. You are a seed that is unraveling. No one can teach you how to be yourself. They can only take care of you and nurse and nurture you around you developing into who you are. No one can teach you how to be you. Your life was predetermined before you were born. Your knowledge, your message that you came to bring, your purpose was embedded in your DNA the day you were born. You cannot teach a tiger how to be a tiger. You cannot teach a lion how to be a lion. You cannot teach a fish how to be a fish. A fish is a fish. A lion is a lion. No one has to teach Aya how to be Aya. Aya was Aya from the day she was born, and she was going to become Aya since the day she was born. So your knowledge is already in you. What you're attracted to, what you innately attracted to, is you trying to find yourself. When you were attracted to the knowledge that led you to achieve, it is you. I am you. I am you. This is you. You match the frequency to the purpose that was inevitably in you at birth as a seed. And if you look back into your timeline in life, you will see that you were always someone that was picking toward this path.
Yeah.
You always were interested in it. Yes. You always were interested. It was always in you to pick the things, to research, to read the things that would lead you to this path. Everything is in divine timing. So this is what we have to understand. If you just look back on your life, it's all written. You were born. No one can. That's why school is stupid.
Right.
School is stupid. Life is the only teacher. You put people in school, and you're actually counteracting their ability to develop. Because the information that you're only giving them, you're giving them how to survive in that world. But you're not teaching them how to become them. Because you can't. You can only allow them to be free and give them the ability. Like the internet gives the internet is freedom, right? The children of these days, they have the internet. Yo, the internet is like, pick what you are. Whatever you innately, you ever notice your children are attracted to certain cartoons?
Yeah.
Pay attention to what the cartoons that they're attracted to, because they're attracted to those cartoons for a reason. You understand what I'm saying? They be like, why did my kid like this fucking cartoon?
Yeah.
And as they develop, your children like certain things. I'm going to tell you a story. My son Osiris, right? He always liked trucks. And I'm like, why does this little dude like trucks so much? Daddy, I want trains and trucks and anything that's driving on a car. Like, he loves trucks, like, just trucks. Just ever since he was little, he was just fascinated with cars and trucks and stuff like that. And then one day, we was in the jungle in Belize, and he just said to me, he said, Daddy, he was like, I was a construction man. Went out and before. And I was like, construction man? What you talking about, Osiris? He said, I was in the construction man. And he was telling me, I was like, son, what do you mean, baby boy? Like, what are you talking about? Tell me what you talking about. He was playing with his remote control car because he loved these trucks. I don't want him to be into trucks and shit. I wanted him to be in the animals. But he wanted to be in the trucks. So I, like, got to give him what he want. So he likes the trucks, the pickup trucks. He really liked the Tonka trucks, you know, the stuff, that dump stuff. He liked any trucks. So I said, He said, I was a construction man before, and a tree fell on me. I cut down a tree and it fell on me. With fine detail, he told me about his past life. He said, a tree fell down on me, and then I woke up with mommy. And I was with mommy. And I was like, what? Nigga, did you just... This nigga really... He told me, he said, Daddy, I was a tree fell on him, and he went to sleep, and then he woke up with mommy.
Wow.
And I said, this nigga was a construction worker, and that's why he liked them trucks. In his past life, he was a construction worker. And I'm like, this little nigga here, bro. You know.
That's crazy.
And,
he loves to be outside.
He likes to be outside? That's rare. That's where I had a chick I was dating and her child was scared to touch the damn earth. She was crying.
That's crazy. 1 year old, you've been outside. Like, if you take him and bring him back inside from outside, hold it.
And you see, no one can teach you how to be you. And that's why school is prison for children. It is a program to program to that system, and it's only teaching them how to be the matrix. It's not teaching them how to be them. It takes parenting. It takes very close, intimate, loving parents to allow a child to see what your child is at a very young age and be able to develop that thing and give them the environment that develops what that child really is and what his true purpose is. This child is constantly trying to show you who it is. So you, as you look back into your lives, you will see your choices and everything that you were attracted to was you trying to develop who you are. Now, there's certain things in life that stop you from developing that and distract you from that because you have to have real life, right? Your dreams get snatched from you. Real life means you got bills, gotta work. Matrix, Babylon. Steals your soul. You understand what I'm saying? So no one can teach you how to be you. You were always going to be here. You were always going to choose me. You were always going to... This is part of your life. You choose this. You understand?
I can definitely see that. I want to be with a dark-skinned man so bad. The universe did not want me to have it.
Wait, what?
A dark-skinned man. Like, I wanted to be with this dark-skinned dude in high school. And the universe is like, no. And I wanted him so bad.
That happened to me too. I always picked the darkest ones in school. And they never, like, I was like,
never.
I see guys who kind of try to talk to me. I'd be like, that's so bad.
I always imagined my husband to be dark-skinned, like, very young, like, dark-skinned.
Wow, that's crazy.
I always like dark skin, like Ra. When I first saw Ra, I was like, man, she's
Zion.
Zion. When I first saw you, I was just like, I fell in love with you. Like when they pulled up to the airport and picked you up, I was like, ooh, she is beautiful.
Nah, she got coconut oil on her lips. We don't do lip gloss.
Yes.
Coconut oil.
Wow. This is Vaseline.
Okay.
That's still natural. Is it okay?
Hey, y'all just need to give it up for Malia. She's beautiful. Like, y'all need to just give flowers. Send flowers for Malia. Don't hate. You know she's beautiful. I hate that y'all hate on her deliberately when you know she's beautiful. Y'all did the same thing to Nana. Y'all did the same thing to Nana. Y'all hated on her. And then as soon as she came over there with y'all, y'all over there praise her. Now, like, oh, we love her now. Get out of here. Come on. Stop. No, just send flowers because she's beautiful.
Yeah.
Don't deny her that. Don't do that. That ain't right. Y'all being devils and demons.
Right.
Yeah.
Y'all gotta stop on that. Like,
so, yeah. That's all I wanted to tell y'all in front of the world. And then what?
For real, when
she got in that bed and it was acting, how you feel about coming? She was like, it feels good. And I was like,
and you know what true, you know what true beauty is? Who could tell? Like, what is your idea of real beauty? Is because somebody's pretty? Is that beauty? Because it's the difference of being pretty and being beautiful. Beautiful is a spirit. That's like, it's a difference between being being pretty or being handsome and being sexy. Sexy is a spirit. Beauty is a spirit. Beauty is a spirit. Like, something can be like, something can be pretty, but it's not beautiful. You understand what I'm saying? A woman can be pretty, but not beautiful. Beauty is an essence. That's an allure. That's something that's that someone that's not very attractive physically can have beauty. You can see the beauty in someone. You understand? So beauty is a spirit. When you say someone's beautiful, you're saying that there's an essence about them. The way they carry themselves, the thing, how they do things. They do things in a way that is just wow. It's so full of beauty. Like, you're a beautiful person. You might be not be that pretty, but you're a beautiful person. You might, you somebody might be not so handsome, but they sexy as shit.
Right.
You understand? This is a spirit. It's a difference. Being pretty is skin deep. It's genetics. You know, we like pretty stuff. Oh, that's pretty. That's good looking. But is it beautiful? It's two different things. Beauty is strength. Substance. Strength is beauty. I think that's the most beautiful thing about a woman is her strength. To be bendable, shapeable, moldable, submissive. To become whatever she chooses to submit to become. That's the beauty of a woman. The allure of beauty. You understand? This is a spirit. True beauty. You don't have to be pretty to be beautiful. You know what I'm saying to you? So it's like, people don't understand spirits. They don't understand the spirits of things. Right? You know, like, so I feel like Beyonce is not the prettiest woman, but she is one of the most sexiest women. She embodies sexy. Okay? She's not the most genetically beautiful woman in the world, or prettiest woman in the world, but she's one of the most powerful and sexy. See, like, power, this sexy is powerful. The way she moves, her spirit is powerful. She calls the other lady in her, whatever, the Sasha, whatever. That spirit is sexy. Sex. You understand? So these are different spirits. You have to be able to acknowledge spirits and then look at the body and be like, oh, the body's good looking. But the spirit, like Aya, you're not sexy. You more like, you're elegant. Not sexy. You're good looking, but you're not sexy. You're elegant, classy, elegance. It's an elegance about you. It's like a regal elegance, more like a older, you know, fancy, smancy white lady. Yeah, like a model. Like, yeah, like a model, like, you know, just elegant. That's the word I use for you, elegant. You understand? Just the elegance about you. Sexy? No. And Ra has the spirit of regal, of, you know? She has a spirit of regalness in her, the way she wants to move. And it's regal. It's the spirit of Zion is regal. It's the only word I can find.
Spirit of a goddess,
you know.
His.
Yeah. That's a spirit, and it's, and that spirit is sexy. You see? The regal spirit is sexy.
Yeah.
So with you, there's elegance. There's classy. There's elegance. You're the kind of woman that's in a gown and you take dancing, but you don't take her to the booty pop club. Pop, pop, pop. This is, yeah, expensive candlelight chandeliers, wine and dine me, elegant. That's the kind of woman you are. And Malia, you are goofy. Like, you look really pretty, but you just goofy as shit, bro. But you know what? Also, you strong. You a strong woman. You are strong, even in your voice and your presence, even though you hide it, but the true essence of you is strong. You a strong woman. Ain't nothing gonna break you. You strong. You ain't letting nothing take you down. You gonna hold your head up, because with spirit, I feel in her is strength. Am I right? This woman's strong.
Yes, okay.
You strong as shit. Mentally and physically, you even got them arms. Like, you strong. Ain't nothing breaking her. That's what I feel like. You know, but oh, that's a strong black woman, because it's just strong. It built like that. That's you. You're strong. And you. You. All of you are pretty. All of you are good looking. You are smart and strong. You got a strength to you. She got the same thing you got. It's a strong. It's a strength to you. And you are artistic. That's how I feel with you. You have an eye for beauty, eye for aesthetics. You're very artistic. You always got the cute outfit on. You always put your... So you have an eye for aesthetics. That's because you're beautiful. That's what you are. You're beautiful.
Yeah.
She's beautiful. There it is. Beauty. You're full of beauty. That's why everything you always do is extra beauty to it. You always put... You're a beautiful person. And beautiful people, they do beautiful things. You know? Yes. You're very beautiful. And strong, too, at the same time. And very smart. You retain knowledge very well. Very smart. You had the second highest score on a test, and nobody knew that. But very smart. Very, very smart, very strong, and very beautiful. That's what I see when I look at you. You know what I'm saying? And so, man, beautiful. That's what you are. All right? Just want to let y'all all know that. I love myself.
I love myself.
Peace.
Some stretching, that's good.
this is real. Let me see what y'all talking about. What? Oh, shit. I know what's going on with you. I know what's going on with you.
What's going on with me?
It's good with that, huh?
That's good, though. Nah, I see what's going on.
What's going on?
This tastes like red lobster. What y'all got in this bread? Mm-hmm. It tastes like red lobster biscuits. Hold on. What y'all got in this goddamn? Hold the fuck on. Hold up. Give me that. Hey, what you put in this? Tastes like it got butter in it. What's wrong? It tastes like a red lobster biscuit. Wrong. No, I know it ain't no butter. There ain't no butter in my house. What's that? Whipped cream? What is it? This is that's the, yeah, sour cream.
Sour cream.
Nah, I'm down. What you got in there? Mm-mm.
She's the master.
That's a fact, Capone. Some to the side. I don't want to eat too much of that. That's too good. I like some good pussy. You gotta get up out of that. Mm-hmm. You gotta do that to me. Mm-hmm. Gay flag on the refrigerator, nigga. That's frequency, nigga. What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
Oh, my God.
I am God. Prism, the light spectrum. The fuck is you talking about? People will try to find anything, boy. I'll tell you. Come on, man. Yeah. Yeah. Go ahead, put your own movie up. Put Avatar on.
Avatar?
Yeah. I don't know. Let's put it on.
You said you wanted to watch The Matrix. Still Avatar? Avatar.
That's right, Tron. Ain't nothing beyond frequency, buddy. That's make-believe. Yeah, what you know about faith? What up? What's good with y'all, man? What y'all doing, man? Hell yeah, she a good-ass cook. That shit. Shit. son in the UK? Nigga, I'm trying to... I think that that's a setup, bro. What you think, bro? I think that's a setup, bro. I think they trying to fucking play games with me, bro. When I was in the UK... Messing with this one joint in the UK, she was like a CEO or some shit. She was a CEO. Nah, I don't know if that's him, bro. I think people just playing games, bro. They probably seen a picture online and seen somebody look like they, you know, young, but it's an old picture. Well, I don't know, man. I don't know what people are. Which I seen the picture, man. That shit crazy. That look like, he look like me too. That's the crazy part. But why not just contact me and hit my inbox? Why not just contact me, hit my inbox, and then let me know, hey, you got a son, but it ain't my fault. I ain't no, you ain't gonna make me out to be no deadbeat dad, nigga. Like, you the one ran off. I don't know him. I wanna know him. She said it was a boy. I can't even lie. She said it was a little boy. But the thing is, why not hit my inbox and just tell me the shit and show me, you know what I'm saying? Why are you putting it online? That shit weird.
You're asking for trouble.
I want to
be a man. You know what
I'm saying? I want to change up my hair and find out.
Why not just, you know what I'm saying? Why do me like that, bro? Why not just hit my inbox? Why you gotta put it online? I think that's an attack on me, man.